Hello and welcome to another build of the series. And once again, we're going to take a very, very big leap from Second World War aircraft to actually to First World War aircraft. I have to say, I'm not a huge fan of making First World War model kits. But it's nice at times to switch back to and from subjects, so there you go. So to kickstart this off, I'm going to show you what we're going to be building. Well, you know what I'm going to be building by the title, but I'm just doing this for the video basically. And it is this kit, the Albatross D2 from Edward. It's a 2007 kit, so it's fairly old kit, but the kit is beautiful inside, absolutely beautiful. Now, I have to apologise about the light if you can't see this very properly, this area here, because light source is a bit weird, as you can see. So, see what I mean? Just trying to move it about, becomes more of a problem. So there you go. We're going to start off by having a look at the kit. Let's go open it up. Beautiful box out, by the way. And to be honest, there's not much to this kit. If you have a look inside, we've got two bags of sprue, instructions. That wasn't there, I just chucked that in. Masks, photo etch, and decals. So it's quite a nice quite amount here. So let's start with the decals. I'm trying to drop the photo etch at the same time, why don't you? Instructions are here. It gives you some information about the Albatross. So starting off with the cockpit, start the ammunition tanks going down here. And I have to say there's a lot of cockpit work going in here. Now this is going to take some time because I'm going to do a wood grain effect to all of this. It's my first time doing this. I've got some oil paints, I've got some white spirit, so we can all get started with it. This moves on to the cockpit walls. Go down to the engine area, put the machine guns on. Once that is done, we start off by putting the actual thing together in the fuselage here. The tail, wings, control surfaces, and then your radiators and lowering going on there. And then finally, you got your struts going in, some nice photo etch detail, and the landing gear going on the bottom there. Finally, the radiator exhaust and the prop. So not a lot to it really. It's going to be a simple, easy kit, but this kit is going to be detailed to the core. Now there are really good masks to help you along with this kit, so that's why there's so many in there. So that's what this sheet's for, tells you which one to go. Now, talking about marking options, there's not a lot to it. I'm tempted to do this one, which is the box art cover one, which was Lieutenant Robert Dyke of Jester 16B. A very nice camo by the looks of it. Well, they all look nice. They're basically, they're all wood grain, the same camo, but have different markings. The reason why I kind of like this one is because you got this nice insignia, but also the German crosses are pure. They don't have like a white background here. But I'm not sure which one to do yet, but anyway, we'll soon get on to that, won't we? So I think about going for this one, William Litch, Jester 19 is option B, Rudolf Freyer von Esbeck from KG-2, Staffel 11, sounds like a World War II squadron to be quite honest, and last but not least, unknown pilot of Jester 16B, the same squadron as the other one. So in all fairness, they're kind of all the same marking options, quite honest. I like this one because it's all pure, all wooden, and got the same things on. So I might go for this one, but apart from that, that is it really. So the kit, not much to it really. Sorry about the noise. That is it. Two bags of sprue. Well, two sprues. And that is all, ladies and gentlemen. Not much really, but it's nicely moulded. Nice interior detail, it's very basic. Some nice detail there. So I can say that it's going to be quite an easy kit, and most of it is taken up by photo etch, really, quite honest. And that's the surprise, you even get a pilot sat there with his arm hanging out. I'm not going to have that on my plane, sadly. So, it looks very nice. I look forward to it now. Just have a look through everything. Photo etch, decals, all there. Now, first thing to do with this kit, and this is why I'm doing it now, basically. I'm going to spray everything that's interior in the Tamiya XF Desert Yellow, either paint, brush paint it or just airbrush it. But either way, I'm going to put some of this on. And once this is fully dry, we're going to put some oil paint on. Now, I've never done this technique before. I've got some oils here, but I'm eager to have a go at it. Basically, it's the oil grain effect. Most aircraft, as you know, are built from wood. So, of course, they're going to have some wood textures to it. Now, it's going to be very fun. I'm not going to... Well, I haven't got... I haven't tried it before, but it's going to be worth the try. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this off camera, but there's plenty of tutorials on the internet and kind of basically how to do it, because it's going to take me quite a while, so that's why I'm doing the kit now before I start anything. Excuse me, sorry. It's going to take a while to achieve this, so I'm going to start now and I shall see you all very much later. I'll see you later, but you're going to see me in next part.
Eternity later.
Right, so we're cracking on with the Albatross now. It has been a week now, actually over. And the wood panels have shown out like this. Nice wood grain effect on the panels there, I don't know if you can see. But I'm just gonna start cutting parts out. So we're going to start with the cockpit. We start off with this side of the fuselage, apparently, according to the instructions. Well, it's best to follow the instructions, know what you're doing, but there you go. You cut this piece out. Just take away the ends there, just carefully, like so. That one actually went okay. Insert that one. And that one at the front there, and not the back. So there you go. I don't know if I can see, but I'm just going to bring this up to a light. And there. I don't know if you can see the wood grain on that, because it's been quite a weird finish on it. There you go. On this, it's actually a bit, I'm just going to zoom in a bit more. Why isn't this focusing? Thank you. Sorry about that. So, I don't know if we can see that, but that's how it's actually turning out. It's about there, basically. So, it's turned out well. First thing, apparently, the instructions tell us to do is to put in this part, the front. This part where the ammo goes on, well, it's like an ammo belt for the machine guns. The Frontier, that's apparently clips in like so. So I'm just going to get the glue, yeah, just let this dry. If it will. This is the problem now, it's... It's going to be a pain, I think. What's that? That's actually sat in there perfectly. Like that, there you go. So, was sat in there perfectly. There we are. So just get that to dry for a bit. So you have to try and get it level as well, the other pieces. As I mentioned, the wood panels were from oil paint, and basically I put a thick layer on, which technically makes it like harder to dry. So I asked a couple of people on Facebook and the ISM page on there, and they said thin everything down, so that's what I did, and it's now completely dry. That was Thursday, I think it was. It's now Saturday, but yeah. So it's been over a week now since I touched this model, and it turns out really, really good. So try and get that level like so. It's the trouble now getting everything together because it's all kind of like one-sided, if you get what I mean. And plus, it's not contacting the plastic much, it's connecting to the so much the oil paint, really. So now what we're going to do is we're going to do the pedals. Now, the pedal, believe it or not, it sits onto this part, which is, I'm just cutting out now, is this part. That's what it sits onto, that metal part, painted dark iron. And you won't believe it, but that is a rudder pedal. It's just basically a wooden stick. That's all it was. I did have a look to see whether there's any wiring to this, and it doesn't look like, which kind of is surprising. Apparently to most things like Rise of Flight game, some actual modelling that I've seen of others, there's just nothing really to it. So I've just had a look to see how it fits on. I'm just going to do it in this part and just glue that piece on like that. There's a little hole underneath there which this fits into. That fits on like so. Make sure to keep it level and straight as well. Like so. I'm just going to hold it down for a bit so it actually sticks to the great frigging thing, which it probably won't do, but I'm just going to rest everything like that. No, that's not going to stick. A bit more on there and see what happens. Doesn't matter which way it goes on. Well, it does. It sticks out, the ends stick outwards towards the pilots. So I'm just the wrong way now. But I could just easily just turn it around. Like so. So that's stuck on like that. Just get a level on the side here. Great. So not best to start, everything's just not sticking or everything's falling apart. Which is kind of annoying really, because I'm going to leave it. It's not still sticking. Let's move on. Next part, we have some... this part here is the side. You can't see it, but I'll show you when I get around to it. This part has some photo etch art. You're supposed to put four pieces on, but They're all kind of fiddly. I don't know if I can see them. Oops. No, very, very fiddly. So I've just put the two on, so I have to be very careful with this piece. So just having a look, how this piece fits onto the front there, like so. Just gonna get the tweezers here, like that. We gotta put some glue around the edge here. And apparently, that fits in like that. That's gone in, no problem. So that's gone, no problem, but they won't stick. That's typical of a kit, basically. Go rest that there for a minute. You stuck yet? Nope, you haven't. Let's go work it in a bit more. Like so. Nope, this ain't gonna stick down. Especially not for the camera also. Please stick. So I'm just gonna rest here for a minute to hold it down. If it doesn't stick. Oh, it has stuck. That's good. So apparently this piece then fits into there, like so. Great, great work. There's actually quite a bit going in here. The sad thing is that everything has to be lined up with the other side, I suspect. Like so. Like that. That's in place, and everything is just driving me mad on this kit, basically. So, there you have it. That is the first part done. The next parts, by the looks of things, include the backs, the backrest, the seat, as well as the control column and other parts. So I'm going to just go away, paint them up, get everything ready, and I'll come back and take on from there. Okay, so while the cockpit is all drying up, we're going to go and start with the engine. Miraculously, it's only 5 pieces in total, so that's pretty simple. Actually, tell I, it's going to be 6 actually, but at the minute we're going to do 5. Because one's too detailed. So sides just cut out along here. I don't know, you won't be able to see, so it's not in focus. Take them out. The engine was a Mercedes, I believe. Let's have a look at the information. Mercedes D3 160 horsepower engine. So back in the day, that was actually a pretty good engine, really. 160 horsepower. Wow. Apparently, but it still wasn't a good. I don't know whether it was a good, but it wasn't a decent motorcycle engine in the day. But there again, there you are. So, cut them off there, and these off here. So, it's literally not a lot along here, just a couple of dabs of glue on there. Just some things on there. The This is a place into position like that. And there you go. There you go. There you have it. That is the main piece of engine put together. So it's not a lot, just two parts. And then we have, actually, I don't know where to put that on last. I'm just having a look now, because there's a piece that goes in here and then around here. So I think I might leave that up separate and do these other pieces around here. So I've got to get the other pieces out. So I'll do four pieces basically, guys. A31. If I can find it, A31. There you are. A31 sits there. And we go of A13 while we're at it. Like so. So just get like here. Try to get the words right this time. Trim these bits off like so. Cut that down. Just get this together now. Apparently this sits on here, like so. Just having a look how it goes, I'm not sure. It looks exactly the same to me both sides, so that just sits there. Is that a touch more glue? The other side there. Actually, it's got to sit there. And then this piece, if I just glue this piece together across the top there. And just looking at everything, goes together like that, from what I believe. So there's actually just quite a bit of a fiddly part, really. Move a fraction across there. This piece fits like into there, like so. So as you can see, it's not a bad engine kit really. Just gotta move this inwards a bit, like so. Pull this back if I can. And that is the main engine complete. I know there's some exhaust on the side there, but I think I might have to paint the engine first and then put them together, so I think I'm just going to leave that to dry for a bit and then we'll get on the painting there. Well, I'll paint up and then we'll carry on from there. Okay, so finally we've got a lot of things together. I have to admit, I apologise, I haven't recorded a lot of things to do. So I'm just going to show you what I've done so far. We've got the sidewalls, the beautiful engine in place, the seating area, And the control column, it's very flimsy parts, all this stuff. I'm just gonna see where another part refocus you. Sorry about that. There you go. The parts now, there's actually quite some nice detail going on in there, guys. There we can see the wood grain and that. But at the side there, you've got your gauge of how much power you're going, and I've even added a decal for that. So that's a bit sad. You've got some control levers going there, you've got your foot pedals, pump starter, no pump starter there at the side here. Now on the other side, we've got a pouch, a black leather pouch, and your throttle and your oil lever there. And that is the sidewalls. That's it, it's not much done. The most hardest piece is the seat, because, oh, sorry, you've got the seat which fits onto this part here, which fits onto the back wall plate, and you've got this plate, well, wood panels that slot underneath there, and they've got to be level. And they were a pain to dry off because they would not dry and stay still. So I've had to use some proper glue here. And that's how everything's been going together really with this. This really hasn't worked that really well in this kit. I think it's the white spirit reacting to it, so it won't dry if you go do the oil paints. So that's that there. You've got your control stick. There's a three, no, sorry, tell I four pieces on there. You've got your actual stick, your handlebar there, photo etch wire there, and your actual part that goes in there. And last but not least, yeah, beautiful engine. I really like that. I painted that well, and that's how it's turned out. And I really love the detail on that. And I don't know if you can see the wood grain effect on there, but that is beautiful. So what we're gonna do is I'm just gonna zoom you out just a touch, and we say from there. But I'm just gonna mark it where we're gonna work from. So I always end up taking you out of shot. So we're gonna work with this radius, finally get this axe together. And now what we're gonna do first is, I reckon, the flimsiest parts, which are these lot here. So I'm just gonna add some glue to the edges here, just don't. I say a touch, I just end up sprueing the whole lot out. And that fits on the bottom there. So that's, this part's come out now, great. A bit of glue on there while I think about it, and a bit of glue there. And now, final part. Put quite a bit along here. And this part fits onto the side. It's a very tight fit, this last panel. So watch yourself, guys. That's, I'm just trying to get my head in the way, sorry about this. And that fits on. Wonderful. I'm sorry, I just have to take you out of shot there to get, see if I can get into, quite flimsy part this is. So once it's in, that is that, right, that is in. Glue these tight. That then is not going anywhere. That is all in place and it looks marvellous. Last part to go in is going to be the engine. Put some glue along there. We're going to fold this in here like so. So I'm just going to let everything set for a while. Now here comes the part of, see if everything fits together. So I'm just actually just adding glue almost everywhere to the inside parts, because just like that. Now for the moment of truth, I'll just add some glue onto the ends here, back of the fuselage, bit there, bit on the front here while we're at it. Let's get this baby together. So this is front nose in, like so. That. Oh, bit of a tight squeeze. Okay, so I'm just checking that everything's in place. That needs to be pushed back just a touch. Just gonna hold this together like so. It's nice and fitting well. And that, resting down, make sure the engine is resting straight upwards. That's another important feature. That is the Albatross, the mainly fuselage in place. Just go press gently there. I actually put some strength into this. It's actually quite a fit. Okay, so check out these panels. That should fit there, so I'm just going to put some glue in there. Like so. Some glue in there. Glue along the engine bay at the back here. And that is everything in. Oh no. Guess that's just fallen out. Sugar. Right, emergency, take this out. There's no way. Great. Right, let's retry this. Very fast drying glue, so there's no way I'm going to get that back out there. Foot pedals came out. Sticking to my fingers. Very fiddly parts, very fiddly parts. That part goes on like that. Very fiddly to handle all these parts, guys, I'm afraid. Let that drive 2 seconds. Like that. So yeah, I'll kind of have a little bit of a meltdown there. So the main part is, I'm just gonna dry and I'm gonna get this part fitted back in straight away. Because you can't have an aircraft without the rudders. Very flimsy part, that's, I suppose, not that bad really. That could just fold back in there. No problem. Right, that's dry. Well, particularly dry. Put some glue aside here. Very small amount that side. Very small amount that side. And make sure you put this, well, I am anyway. Make sure I'm putting this the right way. That. slots into there. Now I'm not moving my fingers for at least a couple of seconds now to let this all dry off. Put some glue back here. At the front here as well. There you have it. That is the albatross looking particularly good together. And that glue is really, really helpful, guys. That is now back in place and level. So, main part is we've got to get all this clamped together so nothing moves. I'll just drop that while I do process. So, we get some last bands and some these parts, like so. Some glue on there. Like so. Right, so I'm going to remove that. Put this elastic band around. Clamp this together like so. And that is really the albatross complete. This little beauty, I just moved that, just realised, sorry, is now all complete. Well, the fuselage is anyway. So that really was the main thing I wanted to get done. Next part, well, I'm going to stop recording, as you can tell, but next part, what we're going to do is we're going to basically get the woodwork painted, but before we do that we need to get the bottom wing in place, as well as the tail and the tail wheel strut piece, so then we can actually paint it in the natural wood effects, which I will. I've actually said to myself I'm going to do a demonstration for you guys so you can finally see what it's like to do woodwork on a First World War kit. So I think this may be the first proper video of someone doing that on here. So with that, thank you very much for watching. I'm just not happy with this piece. Oh well. Anyway, I'll do that later in a minute. Right, thank you for watching. Happy modelling, and I shall see you all later. So with that, cheers and goodbye for now.